वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स. दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 8 फॉर द सब्जेक्ट पावर सिस्टम एंड वन. सो टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द कॉन्स्टेंट्स ऑफ ए ट्रांसमिशन लाइन. सो वी बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस टॉपिक लेट अस डिस्कस सम इंट्रोडक्शन रिगार्डिंग दिस टॉपिक. एज वी नो दैट इलेक्ट्रिकल power transmission is done through three phase wires. So electrical transmission line can be thought to be composed of three constants named as resistance, inductance and capacitance that is uniformly distributed throughout the length of the line. So for the electrical design parameters we can take these constants named resistance, inductance and capacitance as a lumped parameter as shown in figure 1-2 part. As shown in this figure 1-2 part. Okay. So these RLC, resistance, inductance and capacitance of a transmission line are known as constants of a transmission line. So these constants of a transmission line, we have to discuss in detail each constants of a transmission line because the efficiency, voltage regulation and power factor of a transmission line depends upon these constants. So figure 1 shows the single line diagram of a transmission line from the generating end to the receiving end, showing the three parameters are uniformly distributed throughout the length of the line. So for the analysis purpose, let us start with the two parameters, resistance and inductance. Resistance here is taken as lumped, inductance here is taken as lumped parameter. Okay. So let us discuss in detail one by one. What do you understand by resistance? Resistance is basically the opposition offered by the line conductor to the flow of current. That is known as resistance, and the losses which incurred is in the form of heat. Okay? Heat is dissipated due to the resistance of the line conductors. It is shown in this figure number 2 as a lumped parameter ER. As a lumped parameter ER, resistance is shown. So the next one is inductance. For this parameter, we know that when an alternating current flows through a conductor, a changing flux gets linked with it. When a changing flux links with the conductor, the effect of inductance is introduced. So due to the changing flux with the conductor, conductor experiences the inductance effect. So we can say that the inductance can be written as rate of change of flux linkage with respect to current, and its SI unit is in Henry's. So these are the formulas for the inductance, rate of change of flux linkage with respect to current, where and the SI unit is Henry. Phi represents the flux linkage, I represents the current in amperes. So in today's lecture, I am just introducing the three parameters. So we have to discuss in detail all the three parameters throughout this chapter. So the next point will be the effect of capacitance. So if any two conductors are separated by an insulating material, constitutes the capacitance effect. So in the case of transmission line, there are two conductors available in transmission line and the insulation between them is the air. So it is satisfying the first property. If any two conductors are separated by an insulating material, the effect of capacitance is introduced. The insulating material between the two transmission line conductors is the air. So the effect of capacitance is introduced in the transmission line. In order to understand the effect of capacitance, a single line diagram has been drawn. As we look at these two conductors, this is conductor one, conductor two. In between both the conductors, the effect of capacitance can be seen by the dotted lines. So for the electrical design analysis, all these capacitors can be taken as a lumped summation of C, sum of all the capacitances, and the current flowing through the capacitance is the charge current IC. The value for capacitance is charge on the line in coulomb with respect to its potential difference between the conductors. So this is the formula for the capacitance, and this is the effect of capacitance. So at the start we had discussed the resistance and inductance of a transmission line and concluded with the concept of capacitance in a transmission line. So due to this capacitance effect, the charging current IC starts flowing even though there is no load connected across the receiving end, or in the case of open circuit, the charging current still exists. The charging current, due to the charging current, what is going to happen? Due to the charging current, the voltage drop efficiency as well as power factor of the line gets affected to a greater extent. So the concept of charging current while designing the electrical design parameters is very important because it affects the voltage regulation efficiency and somehow power factor of a transmission line to a greater extent. So in today's topic, we had covered all the introduction regarding the constraints of a transmission line. Thank you guys.